We want to welcome all of you here today. We're delighted so many came to be with us today as we celebrate All You Need Is Love, giving thanks for the Beatles. I, along with many of us in this room, grew up in 50s America, and the post-war economy was booming, and everybody was, doing better than they had, and as the world recovered from war. And so America hatched this giant economy, and before you knew it, according to President Eisenhower, we had the military-industrial complex, and we had lots of values that we look back to as good, and there were good values, but we also began to hatch values of materialism and consumerism that have now led to a climate crisis, among other things. In the midst of all that, in the Vietnam War and the Civil Rights Movement, 60s music started to happen, and so there were many, many, many voices that came out in opposition to some of the cultural norms that were developing. And some of those voices were beautiful and some were strident, but the Beatles' voice was unique. And part of why it was unique was that, especially in their short tenure, relatively short tenure as a band, they began moving more toward a simple but profound spirituality. The anthem that we're basing the title of today's program on, All You Need Is Love, perhaps expresses that best. And you'll notice that at the end of our time today, the benediction is based on the epistle of 1 John, in which he makes the bold statement, God is love. So I think John, the writer of 1 John, and the Beatles were on the same page. And now, almost 60 years later, we need this message again. And so as we approach Thanksgiving this Thursday, we thought, let's give thanks for the Beatles. And let's give thanks for the simple but profound and powerful message that human beings are indeed capable of love and community, and a lot of what we will be celebrating today. So to have so many of you here with us today gives all of us a chance in Thanksgiving week to be in community with each other. And so thank you for coming, all of you in person and all of you who are on Facebook Live. And if you know someone who missed this, it will be on our Facebook Live page, our Facebook page, our church Facebook page, and our remarkable technology integrator, that's the title Jock has here at First Church, will eventually turn today's program into a YouTube video on our church's YouTube channel, Concord's First Church. And it'll be excellent quality audio and video. By the way, This is really exciting.
It's a good segue,
today. Yeah, thank you. This is our first jazz sanctuary with our brand new sound system. And from it, we can record really, really well. So the recording will be great. What people like me create to be recorded is another question, but we'll do the best we can. You have in your bulletins a reading to begin with. Mm-hmm. And
we've got parts, the band's got parts, y'all have parts. The deacons, I don't know if you guys saw, you specifically have a part.
Yeah. Get ready.
Yeah, everybody get ready.
All the jazz deacons, get ready.
From the letter to the Galatians, chapter 5, verses 22 and 23, from the Voice translation. The Holy Spirit produces a different kind of fruit.
Unconditional love.
Joy.
Peace.
Kind-heartedness.
Goodness.
Faithfulness.
Nice. You won't find any law opposed to fruit like this. Amen. can buy me love. Love.
Stick around and it may show.
Done, everybody. Nicely. Yesterday, all my troubles seemed so far away. Now it looks as though they're here to stay. Oh, I believe in yesterday. Suddenly, not half the man I used to be. There's a shadow hanging over me. Oh, I believe in yesterday. Why she had to go, I don't know, she wouldn't say. I said something. Was such an easy game to play. Now I need a place to hide away. Oh, I believe in yesterday. Why she had to go, I don't know, she wouldn't say. I said something's wrong. Was such an easy game to play. Now I need a place to hide away. Oh, I believe in yesterday.
Here comes the sun, do 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 do. Here comes the sun, and I say it's alright.
Again, so glad to have all of you here. Hi, Brandy. Come on in. We would not be doing this without some additional help. So I want to begin by saying that our technology integrator, producer, arranger of music, and copier of scores, a bass player, and all-around musical overlord, made this happen almost single-handedly, and his name is Jock Irvin. Anybody tells you that the Beatles music is, you know, simple and easy, forget about it. This is really wonderful. That the fact that in those days and in those times, four young men from Liverpool came up, especially Lennon and McCartney, came up with this body of music is phenomenal. Jock has scores to all the Beatles music, and from that created our instrumentation today. So it's, for those of you who are musicians, you know what this music is like. Musically, for all of us, we know how wonderful and appealing it is. So thanks to Jock. Again, this week, ask for your prayers for our good friend Eddie Raska, who is our Jazz Sanctuary drummer. I always call him the spiritual drummer. Eddie is still in Concord Hospital in the intensive care unit. He's doing better. He's perhaps being transferred out of there today. But we send our love and our prayers to Eddie, and we are so, so fortunate in his absence to have a wonderful drummer today. Jock met him when he subbed with a group in out of Manchester. Some of you may have heard of the Scott Spradling Band. It's hard to say fast. The Scott Spradling Band, and his name is Fred Hebert, And we're so glad to have you with us today, Fred. Thank you. We also are very indebted today to a guitarist who knows the Beatles and loves the Beatles. He's too young to be so good on the Beatles, but he is anyway. Eric is the, for many years, he was the founding guitarist in the Tall Granite Big Band. He doesn't play with us anymore because he finally got smart enough to spend time with his family instead of a bunch of old guys. But he's a wonderful, wonderful guitarist. He also plays with Mr. Aaron's band, and he is owner with his dad of Strings and Things Music Store. Welcome to us today, Eric Bilodeau. Well, we have, you know, the world's greatest entertainer. You know, if he weren't here, he'd probably be in Vegas. So we're but you got to admit, the only guy here today on the bandstand that has a Beatles haircut is Joey Placenta. And it's real. It's real.
It's real.
If the Beatles had gotten gray and, you know, still were with us in the original form today, this is what they'd look like. As always, the musical, spiritual, collaborative energy of this endeavor for almost 8 years, in March will be since we started Jazz Sanctuary, and the pastor of First Congregational Church here in Concord, an incredible voice and presence, the Reverend Amelia Halstead.
And this is Tim Wildman, who, you know, plays the trumpet and plays the piano, but also birthed the whole thing. And I'm so, so glad that he did, that we reason we are all here. So thank you, Tim, for
thank
birthing
you.
It.
Thank you. We also have Jean and Brenda and Carol serving as our jazz deacons today. And so we want to thank them for their work as well.
And before I forget, since our, what did you call him, our musical overlord? if we could have two tall people, once we're all done, we've got our two banners out front that need to come down. I can't reach them, if that tells you anything about how tall they need to be. So to help us bring down our banners after, but that's neither here nor there. We are going to enter into our official worship service now, our jazz worship experience, and this is where we invite you all to sing with us. This is Thanksgiving Sunday, traditionally, and so we are also going to sing some of our favorite Thanksgiving hymns, the first being We Gather Together. And we're going to invite Joey to play it through us on flute and everybody else, and then we'll sing all three verses together.
Please now.
also invite you to join with us in our opening words by Thich Nhat Hanh, saying together, when we live in the spirit of gratitude, there will be much happiness in our life. The one who is grateful is the one who has much happiness, while the one who is ungrateful will not be able to have happiness. Amen. Additional reading today. We did Galatians at the beginning. Our additional reading is 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verses 4 through 8a and 13. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love isn't envious, doesn't boast, brag, or strut about. There's no arrogance in love. It's never rude, crude, or indecent. It's not self-absorbed. Love isn't easily upset. Love doesn't tally wrongs or celebrate injustice. But truth, yes, truth, is love's delight. Love puts up with anything and everything that comes along. It trusts, hopes, and endures no matter what. Love will never become obsolete. But now faith, hope, and love remain. These three virtues must characterize our lives. The greatest of these is love. Amen.
Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these broken wings and learn to fly. All your life. This moment to rise. Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these sunken eyes and learn to see. your life. You were only waiting for this moment to be free. Blackbird, fly. Blackbird, fly. Into the night of a dark black night. Singing in the dead of night, take these broken wings and learn to fly. All your life you were only waiting for this moment to rise. You were only waiting for this moment to rise. You were only waiting for this moment to
We don't have sermons at Jazz Sanctuary, so we can breathe a sigh of relief.
can breathe a sigh of relief. Yeah, I don't know about you, but...
I did my preaching quotient last year.
Oh, yes, you did.
Yeah, I'm good for the next 2 years.
Yeah.
But we always have a conversation, and we all do the preaching together. Mm-hmm. And so we have a focus question, and... We have two.
We do.
Okay.
I threw the other one in there from the cards.
Oh, I didn't. I see I'm looking at the wrong program.
No,
okay.
No, you're good.
Okay.
Just start with that one.
Okay. So based on our reading that we had at the beginning of our time today on spiritual gifts, we're just wondering what spiritual gift or gifts you have or would like to have. And you're not limited to the spiritual gifts listed at the beginning from Paul. But this is a time in a long time, it's the time that we need everybody's spiritual gifts. And so what spiritual gift, you know, this is like a pledge drive.
Which spiritual gift will you give us this year?
Exactly. What spiritual gift are you willing to pledge?
Yeah.
In these times.
Yeah.
Yeah. Don't be bashful. Speak right up. Yes,
yeah,
Jean.
I raised five children, four teenage daughters, so I am patient.
Amen. Bless you. Patience it is.
Hey. And one of them became a minister. I don't know what to think about that, but
yeah,
that's
no,
good.
Me neither.
Yes, Brenda.
Mm-hmm.
Helpful. Always be helpful. That's mm-hmm. great. Yes.
Always love God.
Always love God.
God.
There's the
Amen.
Love.
All right.
Amen.
Yes.
I substitute teach in an elementary school. I profess kindness.
Mm.
Amen. Yes. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yes.
Optimism.
Yeah, yeah, we need that, don't we?
There's no law against that either. No.
No. Optimism and hope. Yes.
Yes.
Mm. Yes.
Openness.
That's great.
Mm-hmm.
Other spiritual gifts that you have or would like to have and would like to pledge? Yes.
Understanding.
Yeah, great. Yes.
Art.
Mm-hmm. It is a spiritual gift.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Music.
Music.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Gratitude.
Hey.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Not just this week, but every week.
Yes.
Yes. Yes, and back. Oh.
Knowledge.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Knowledge, and yes.
Ears for listening.
Ears for listening.
Listening.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Right. You mean not just for shiny objects?
on the side of our heads? Yes.
Yeah. Say again? Art? Yes, yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yes. Tolerance. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it goes along with understanding and listening. Mm-hmm. Yes, Brian.
Acceptance.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Suzanne. Mm-hmm. Healing from mental illness. That is a great gift.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah.
You shout it out later. Yeah. We do the popcorn stuff.
God knows what it was, Brian.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. I got to say, okay. Helping others.
Great.
My favorite, as will not surprise most people, joy.
No. Dawn?
Mm.
Mm. Stubborn for justice.
Stubborn
I like
that. Yeah. Yeah.
Yes. That's great. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yes. Faith. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm. Shall I tie in the second part of the question?
Yes, please do.
Which fruit of the Spirit feels most challenging to you, and why?
Mm. How did I miss that question?
Well, that was, again, in the bulletin.
Okay,
that was
that's why I missed it.
Yeah. Which of the love, joy, peace, patience, kind-heartedness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control?
Uh-oh.
Which, I know which one mine is. which fruit of the Spirit feels most challenging to you, and why?
Big uh-oh. Brian, did you?
Not short-term memory. I don't think you're alone on that one, Brian. Unconditional acceptance. Yeah. On love.
Yeah. Yes, Rebecca.
Forgiveness.
Yeah. That's very challenging.
I think one of the hardest ones for me is gentleness, because our society demands much more than that. Gentleness is often squashed. Mm. So even wanting to enter into a space or a way that is gentle, I think quickly gets run over. So others. Yeah. A voice knowing when to speak.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Patience is difficult. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yes, David.
The struggle of balancing love and truth.
Mm-hmm.
One extreme or the other.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
The struggle is fun.
Mm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Love is the most natural and yet, I think, sometimes the most difficult.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Dealing with accepting that one's getting older, I'm getting older.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Accepting that one is getting older.
Right. And we all are.
Yes. Since the day we're born.
Yes, exactly. Exactly right.
Yeah. Any others? Done. Enough said.
Hello.
We're going to invite you to join us in closing this time of conversation with the prayer that is printed in your bulletin, saying together, gentle God, your faithfulness abounds, your love endures, your grace is a holy mystery. May we share these gifts every chance we get. Amen.
Trouble, Mother Mary calls to me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. And
Amazing dancers. It makes everything so much better. So we're going to enter now into a time of prayer. And I'm going to just invite folks, if you are so moved to do so, to, as we say in camp, popcorn style, shout out the prayers that you've brought with you this afternoon, either prayers of joys, prayers of concerns, prayers of any type. Or are certainly in the silence of your heart, knowing that God hears all of our prayers, no matter how we share them. So let us be first in this space of a popcorn prayer.
Prayers for Eddie and prayers for Everett.
Prayers for Eddie and prayers for Everett. Thanks for medical miracles. Prayers for the Hardy family.
Prayers for in many communities today, it's Transgender Day of Remembrance. Remembering the number of folks that have been killed.
Yes, prayers for all of our transgender siblings, and for all of those, especially this year, who have been murdered. In ignorance and hatred.
Prayers for safe travel.
Prayers for safe travels.
Prayers for those who are blind.
Prayers for those who are blind. Prayers for all those who enter this season of Thanksgiving and Advent and Christmas with heavy and grieving hearts. Prayers for the family of Dan Young. Loving Spirit and giver of every gift, We open our hearts to you. We seek love, to be loved and to love, to be lovers, to be love. Infuse us with the love that is you, such a gift, while being beyond our wildest imaginings is the gift we most long for, search for, and hope for. It is indeed a gift and not something we can buy. Can't buy me love indeed, O Spirit. Yet without that love of yours, we know that our very breath itself would cease and the rhythms of creation would fall silent. So while we seek this gift of love, we know that you have already given us this gift beyond price. You give it now, and we trust you will give it to all creation forever. All praise to you, loving Spirit and giver of every gift. Amen. And let us join now together as we get the band back together in our next hymn, Great is Your Faithfulness. One, two, three.
Great is your faithfulness, O God, Creator. With you no shadow of turning we see. You do not change, your compassions they fail not. All of your goodness forever will be. Great is your faithfulness. Great is your faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, your hand hath provided. Great is your faithfulness, God unto me. Summer and winter and spring,
and to guide strength for today and bright hope for tomorrow. Blessings are born with 10,000 beside. Great is your
this time of prayer by sharing together the Lord's Prayer as printed in your bulletin, translated from Neil Douglas Klotz in the Aramaic. O birther, father, mother of the cosmos, Focus your light within us. Make it useful. Create your reign of unity now through our fiery hearts and willing hands. Help us love beyond our ideals and sprout acts of compassion for all creatures. Animate the earth within us. We then feel the wisdom underneath supporting all. Untangle the knots within so that we can mend our hearts' simple ties to each other. Don't let surface things delude us, but free us from what holds us back from our true purpose. Out of you, the astonishing fire, returning light and sound to the cosmos. Amen. As we transition into our Agape Feast, we are going to sing yet another favorite Thanksgiving hymn, Now Thank We All Our God. If you know the German, you are welcome to sing in German. Just saying. Welcome, and all are free to come and to eat. As we gather at this place and continue in worship, we remember these words of our brother Jesus. I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me shall not hunger, and whoever believes in me shall never thirst.
We come to this table hungry and thirsty, seeking to be satisfied. As we gather at this table, we remember these words of our brother Jesus. Come to me, all you that are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest.
We come to this table weary and burdened, seeking rest. As we gather at this table, we remember that Jesus comes to us in those who are strangers to us, in those who are hungry, in those who are thirsty, and in those needing warmth.
We come to this table as strangers in a strange land. We ask with humble confidence that you welcome us into your family, O God.
And let us pray together the prayer of adoration as you will find printed in your bulletin. Living God, you are present in our midst, and we praise you. You are tearing down walls of alienation and exclusion. For this we praise you, because in Jesus you have shown us a way of hospitality, simplicity, prayer, peacemaking, and resistance. Because your Spirit makes a new path for us as we struggle to live in the shadow of doubt and fear. Weak as we are, you fill us with hope. Lover of our souls, you give us joy, and we praise you. Amen. And so we do take joy in this meal, where we give our love and our attention to one another, and remember that Jesus too is here with us. In the midst of this sacred meal, we set three symbols to remind us of Jesus' promises to us.
A candle to remind us that Jesus poured out his Holy Spirit upon us, giving us new life, new power, and new hope. We, filled with the Spirit, bring the presence of God into a broken world.
And bread in the form of goldfish crackers, for Jesus is the bread of life. He nourishes us, and we put our trust in him.
Grapes, a reminder of his struggle for justice and for peace, a reminder of his suffering at the hands of the Roman Empire. He suffers still when the oppressed suffer injury at the hands of the powerful.
Jesus is with us in this Agape Feast, so let us open our hearts to God and to one another as we feast in this love feast together. We invite you now to share, and if you've seen the movie Ratatouille, maybe not, you know that if you have a grape on itself and if you have a cheese cracker on itself, they're both tasty, but when you have them together, it does a whole new thing with the body of Christ. So anyway, take and eat, dear friends. So we're going to share with you the benediction, the peace, and then we are going to join together in our sending music. And I know you can follow us on this one, because truly, all you need is love. So from the 1 John letter, chapter 4, verse 7, my loved ones, let us devote ourselves to loving one another. Love comes straight from God, and everyone who loves is born of God and truly knows God. Amen. But you can learn how to play the game. It's easy. Nothing you can make that can't be made. No one you can save that can't be saved. Nothing you can do, but you can learn how to be in time. It's easy.
Is all you need.
all you need. Love is 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 all you need. Yeah, yeah. Thank you, friends. Thank you for being here. Thank you for all of your love. Go in peace. And if you feel like helping with chairs and banners, you're welcome to do so.